I don't be with him, he's so basic. Well, you the op and your bros hating. All of them fake, I see both faces. Scared of the whip, it's a ghost racing. I knock them down to their cold cases. Marathon run, I'ma slow pace it. They did not want me to go places. Foil plans like the gold place. And if we pulling up with the whole squad, I already done told y'all that you better be running. I'm in my goal yard. When I walk in, I know y'all telling me nothing. I'm the man. Suck it if y'all in denial. I get the chip on him and I bust out the south side. It's that Vigo de Gallo. Stop it, quiet, if it's new, I done got it. See my jewels, shining, white diamonds, Miley Cyrus. Private jet, private pilot, look at me, stylish. Masterpiece, bought it, dumb. Hey, I don't know no, but I'm on this every day. You cannot run with me, boy, I'm a heavyweight. Baby, I know what's coming, I can barely wait. And when it was on, they wanted me gone, boy, I'm here to stay. Stop calling me lil' bro, I got mileage on me. Up in my pocket, I don't want pause to get wild nonsense. We got momentum, don't try to stop it. Diamonds are clearer than my conscience. I don't let bygones be bygones. It's that's when I'm honest. Penthouse building, reach heaven's heights. Nah, that's what you call a God complex. Remember the days I was down low when it was out cold, but I went out and got it. Look at my milestones, man, it feel like the Dow Jones when you look at my pocket. Look at the flex, yeah. Whipping the Teslas. Ooh, I'm a mess, but I'm a ooh. It's all a finesse. Boy, yo, stop it, quiet, if it's new, I done got it. See my jewels, shining, white diamonds, Miley Cyrus. Private jet, private pilot, look at me, stylish. Masterpiece, bought it, dung. Hey, I don't know no, but I'm on this every day. You cannot run with me, boy, I'm a heavyweight. Baby, I know what's coming, I could barely wait. And when it was on, they wanted me gone, boy, I'm here to stay. Stop calling me little bro, I got mileage on me.
Texans taking on the champions from the NFC, the Carolina Panthers. second and five. Gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
Well, Brandon, we could see that play developing, and they were hoping that he was going to be able to put a move on the first guy and turn it into a big play. But no such luck. The speed on defense continues to get better and better in the NFL. Pretty nice example there of those guys being able to run from their assignments and finish off that play.
An early tough test on the opening drive. This is third and eight. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He's going to drop this down to McCaffrey. And this effort will not get it done. He stopped well short of the first down at the 29. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of two there. Send out Michael Pilardi to kick it away. A 40-yard punt, 1 yard on the return.
The Texans take over.
And the Texans will take over with a first and 10. So out come the Texans for their opening drive. They will be led out by their dual-threat quarterback, the veteran from Clemson. It's Deshaun Watson.
Might have won back-to-back Heisman trophies if the ballot had come after the national championship games that he and Clemson played against Alabama. But when you watch him on the field, you realize why coordinators and head coaches want to bend their offense to his talents, because when he's got the ball in his hands, he can be magical at times.
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16-yard gain. Rashad Penny, first carry for the former San Diego State Aztec. Now whistles here, and it looks like we've got a Panther that's having some difficulty down there getting up. We'll check on his status when we get back. Coming up on second and seven. The gun, Watson. And he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. A gain there of 21 yards.
Well, for teams that like to play man coverage, running corner routes can be tough on them because of the ability of getting into it. Sometimes you're squaring it off, sometimes you're just rounding it, sometimes there's a fake, sometimes there's not. That makes it very, very difficult for a DB to stay with it.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 30-yard line. A handoff to Penny. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. No gain on the play there. Second down.
No gain on the play. Second and 10.
Throwing on second down. Watson, they set up the screen to Penny. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that's going to lead to a third and 12.
Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, you're crediting your defense.
Got to credit them on that one because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them. Ran a screen, and they went to it and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
Throwing on third down, Watson. This is caught. It's Cooks. And they move this all the way down to the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate, gotten the ball downfield, gained nice chunks of yardage. But now, in this situation, the field is really condensed, partner. So if he's going to throw the football, that would be pinpoint here.
I was going to ask you about that. Field shrinks, has to be sharper, but it's been a good opening drive so far.
Now they just want to see if they can cap it off with the bell ringer and put it in the end zone.
And he'll take this from the 9 down to about the 7. The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on 2nd and goal.
Brings up 2. Brings up 2nd and goal.
Watson. He's caught. Touchdown, Texans. With the first touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Texans have taken the early lead. Well, you've got to like that start on both sides of the football. You force the 3-and-out, and then you score on your first drive.
Well, I know someone who doesn't like that start.
Well, yeah, the other side.
Yeah, they don't like that at all, right? This is not the way it's supposed to be. But what you just described, that's team football. All right, when you get a 3-and-out, you're supposed to take advantage of it on the offensive side of the ball. You said, thank you very much for getting us the rock. Let's put it in the end zone, and they did exactly that.
Extra point attempt to come here. Texans take a 7-0 lead. So that drive takes them down the field in 8 plays. And it results in the Texans finding the end zone. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. This will make it into the end zone. And Moore, he's going to sit on this one, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. The Panthers coming back out onto the field for their second drive. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up 1st and 10. The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down. Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on 2nd and 10. Slipped one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with 3rd and 11. The defensive coordinators love that. You got a cornerback willing to stick his nose in there, come up on run support, and stop that pop pass dead in its tracks.
And, partner, one good thing about trying to defend that play, you should see it coming the whole way. You see the receiver coming in motion in your direction. Nice job eluding the blocker, making the play behind the line of scrimmage, but an even better job studying the play before you have to try and defend it in the game.
He'll get this underneath to McCaffrey. And he'll be brought down at the 28, and that is well short of the first. 5 yards, not enough, and it'll be 4th down.
Well, the good thing about covering any game I do with you is I know that there's no problem with rhythm. Now, what we're watching offensively, a little bit of a problem there.
Yeah, punt on the first drive, looking at another one here. Just a little slow. And, you know, they were talking about a fast start, but that hasn't been the case.
Yeah, and let's face it, any team we cover always talks about a fast start.
That's true.
But it's not necessarily going to happen just because they say so. And whether it's the script, whether it's, you know, just what they're going through, whether they're seeing different defenses, they'll have to figure it out as this game moves on.
It'll be a 44-yard boot, just a yard on the return as he's covered up quickly. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. So now we get set to see Houston for their second drive of the ball game. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. I mean, look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up 2 touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Good yardage there on 1st down, exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making 1st downs, keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your 2nd down play.
All right, McKinner here, it's complete. His first catch of this Super Bowl, and it'll be good for a first down. Now Rashad Penny, and that play went nowhere. Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Let's face it, that's just a helpless feeling for a running back there. He's looking up to find a hole, and all he finds is a whole lot of ticked off linebacker.
As we hit the midway point of this first quarter. On second and 11 now. Watson dumps that off to Penny, his running back. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. He'll wind up getting 11 on that one. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. They'll try run for it with Penny. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48.
Texans.
5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
Just about every coach we talk to says the crowd shouldn't affect us. That shouldn't be an issue. And then the next breath they talk about taking the crowd and taking them out of the game by picking up first downs and keeping them at bay. I think we just saw an example of that there, didn't we?
It's important to do, especially early in the game like they have. So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. And they run the option here on first and 10. Penny hit, and the ball is germ free.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home, the next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. The fumble on first down now. Here's second down. Now it's Penny. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Now after the play, it looks like there's a Texan here slow to get up. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third. From the gun, here's Watson, eluding the pressure right. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 28. That good for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on third.
Stingham at the 28-yard line.
Down, it's Watson. And they move this all the way down to the 9. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
It's almost as if they didn't leave the field after their first drive. They picked right up where they left off. Another good throw there. And this offense humming here in the early going.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll try and run for it with Penny. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Tackling's obviously critical down near the goal line. That was great work there to make the hit behind the line and make sure he doesn't get any further. Did a really nice job wrapping up and not letting him loose.
Moved back to the 10. They'll try on second and goal here. A shotgun snap for Watson. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. Brandon Cooks, the receiver he was going after. But now it's third and goal.
It's now third and goal.
From the gun, Watson. Buying time to his left. Decent gain on the scramble to six, but now it's fourth. Now Joey Sly and the Panthers' field goal unit. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And his kick is indeed good. And the lead moves to 10-0.
Texans 10, Panthers nothing.
So good kick there to polish off the drive with 3 points.
Yeah, coaches always talk about finishing a drive with a kick. Two of them give you points, either an extra point or, in this case, a field goal.
DJ Moore on the
bench. And he stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Now the Panthers' offense, they get set to come back onto the field. And this is their third drive right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and four.
It's a pickup of six.
Well, we all know the guy carrying the ball is going to get the credit both in the stat line and probably in the newspaper. But guess what? Those guys creating holes, they couldn't feel better about themselves right now. Offensive line, tight end, probably even the wide receivers are involved. They're moving the ball well.
And they got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a third and two more. They'll try and pick it up in McCaffrey. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
I
apologize in advance, partner, but the beef eaters on the interior of this D-line, you just know they were licking their chest. And yes.
Here's Michael Pilardi now, as he's on to punt for Carolina. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. A 40-yard punt, no return.
First and 10 at their own 23.
Set to take over again, Deshaun Watson and his Texans offense. And he's been busy with his feet. He's been quite the scrambling man.
And obviously that can break down a defense, but a lot of it is just that they just get trapped with worrying about it so much that other things break down as well. You know, you break the huddle and you're not just playing what comes out at you. You're like, oh God, don't let him outside of the pocket. Don't let him beat us with his legs. And then he starts to beat you other ways.
Looking sideline, incomplete. From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10.
He was covered by Dante Jackson.
This is Penny. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
Came out in a power set, but that only served to put more men in the box. And guess what? If you're going to do that, you've got to win up front, right? Your offensive guys have got to beat the defenders. They lost all leverage on that play.
Watson now on third down. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
Well, they came up with points in their first two possessions, but it looks like they'll come up empty here on their third drive. The defense finally starting to get locked into them a little bit. Might have to go a little bit deeper into their playbook on their next possession.
Roughing the kicker. Defense. That's not good enough, man.
That hurts. If it was running into the kicker, wouldn't be a first down. Roughing, it is a first.
And just think about the differences between the two. Running into the kicker almost feels inadvertent, just a small tap, so to speak. But when you rough him, here's your bodies are hitting the ground and flying all different places. And the difference is 5 yards or 15. And in this case, that's a big play.
And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of three.
40-yard line. It's a pickup of three. Brings up second and seven.
Now a play fake, and it's Watson. Throw left side complete. It's four. And they'll get this right past midfield before being stopped just before the 35.
And 10 at the 37-yard line.
Nothing to score after one on EA Sports.
Panthers nothing.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They'll run with Penny here out of the shotgun. Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. Tackle made there by Camille Correa.
A gain of two. Brings up second and eight.
From the 35 on second down, Watson throwing right, and that's complete. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 22-yard line. A fresh set of downs on a gain of 13 there for the Texans.
Well, they obviously read man coverage their partner, and he got downfield, broke down the defender, made him
think.
What
do you mean by that?
Yeah, he made him think he was going to run a different route. Probably thought he was going to take it upfield, then it curls back inside for the completion.
Penny, a first down carry. And this has been a recurring theme tonight for sure. Nowhere to run. Back to the line of scrimmage, that's all.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10.
Looking to throw on second down. Watson, that's caught by Penny. Just a 1 yard pickup on the play, and it'll be third and 10.
A gain of a yard. Brings up third and 10.
Operating from the gun, Watson. And this is going to be incomplete.
Watson's pass.
So many offense walking through their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out and check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
Makes the score Texans 13. Panthers nothing.
So good kick there to polish off the drive with 3 points.
Yeah, coaches always talk about finishing a drive with a kick. Two of them give you points, either an extra point, or in this case, a field goal.
And Moore, he's going to sit on this one, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. They find themselves down 13-0 here as they try to get things started offensively. First and 10. They'll start with the option. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. They have to run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10.
Damian Williams on the carry.
The Panthers on third down. 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This will be third and 6.
And 6.
Over the middle, it's complete. First down as they're able to get the third down conversion. He was a 1,000-yard receiver during the regular season, and that's his first catch of this Super Bowl, and he picks up the first down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Short throw to the tight end, Thomas. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10.
Second and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. J.J. Watt in there to get him. It's a loss of 5.
A loss of 5 yards. And it's third down. Third and 15.
Yeah. The Panthers on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This will be third and 15. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he's got his target. That's Moore. And he is going to have the Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on third and 15. 7-yard line. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. This is McCaffrey. And he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Now a man open down the middle of the field. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans' 12-yard line. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And he is caught at the 7-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first. Second and 4. They could still get a first down without scoring.
Second and 4 at the 6-yard line.
Back to the ground attack here. It's McCaffrey. And he gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4. Now whistles here, and it looks like we've got a Panther that's having some difficulty down there getting up. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. So they need 2 yards here on third down. Remember, they're already 2 of 2 on third down conversions on this drive. And he'll take it across for a Panthers touchdown. From 4 yards out, and the Panthers are able to get this back within a touchdown.
Obviously, Brandon, they couldn't get it all back with just one score, but that touchdown chips into the lead, and now it makes the comeback a little bit more manageable.
Graham Gano on for the extra point. And that'll make it 13-7. So that one a long 11-play drive. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. So here comes the kickoff, and what now is just a one-score, 6-point game. Taken in at the 3. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23.
First and 10. At their own 23-yard line.
But let's gaze our attention as the offense takes the field on Rashad Penny. He's hoping to get it going. They're hoping to get him going, too. You know, he's about ready to pop one here in the second quarter. He's hoping.
And his offensive line teammates, they want to get one of those, too, because they want to continue to run the football. Most offensive linemen like that part of the game better than pass protection because they're not taking blows. They're actually dealing them out. So what they want to do is show the coaches, hey, if we pop one, we're having success. That way they won't go away from the running game.
He'll be hoping to pop one, break one here this go-around. Penny.
Brings up second and 10.
And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They want it in every position, and we just saw there some linebackers who can go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
And not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. The Texans on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third down and 12. From the gun, Watson. He finds his target, Fuller. And he is going to have a Texans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Four catches already here in this Super Bowl. He's got another first down. Throw is Watson. Now they go screen. It's complete. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36.
Partner, when you see a screen pass and the defensive tackle ends up making the play, you know that one wasn't sold well at all, because he should be upfield by the time you throw the pass. If not, you end up with big trouble, as we just saw right there.
So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. Operating from the gun. Watson. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game, because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion. I feel like my man, Old Mo, momentum might be changing jerseys right now. How about what they just got done? They scored a touchdown their last drive. Now here's a three and out. Maybe momentum's getting ready to creep to the other sideline.
37 yards on the punt with no return. The Carolina offense about ready to go. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down to those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get low in those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the pass.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something, because right now, they're just cutting them to shreds.
Now a quick slant as the throw's complete. The 20, 10, touchdown! Have tied this game up. They can take the lead with the extra point. And nothing too crazy there. A quick slant, and then he just had a seam. He found a seam.
And when you hit it on the run like that, and I mean the pass right to the receiver who's already in motion and moving, sometimes he just takes it and runs away from everyone else.
And he ran it into the end zone. And the defense, they've got to adjust there quickly. That's tough on them.
That's really tough, because everything was executed well. Ball was out of his hands quickly, into the hands of the receiver, and then he was gone.
And this puts him on top by a penny. It's 14-13. The long touchdown pass gets him six on a very, very tidy two-play drive that time. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Taking it about the one. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further, as he's dropped at the 23-yard line.
At their own 23-yard line.
Deshaun Watson and the Texans offense trot back out there. Been a decent start for him here in this first half, but bottom line, his team's losing. They got to fix something.
And it starts with him. He has to keep that little quarterback strut going right now to make sure his team sees him as confident. Continue to try and up his game, but just let him know, hey, if I'm around, if I'm the one calling signals and throwing the football, just follow me, we'll get there. Sometimes that will do more to elevate a team than anything else.
See if he has that confidence. Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Throwing again is Watson. Penny. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. The Texans on third down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. They're up against a third and one situation. And he finds Stills complete. And he is going to have a Texans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. His second catch of the Super Bowl, and it's good enough for a first down. So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field. Defensively, make sure you know where he is because he understands how to get open in key situations.
The run, it's Penny. And some room to work. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. When he runs, he seems to do a nice job of knowing when to be patient and find the hole. And then when the hole is there, he goes quickly.
You're exactly right. He knows how to just take off. But you know what else? He brings a little thump with him, doesn't he?
He does.
He packs the boom at the end of the run and finishes it going forward. That's what you want to see out of your backs.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Watson, off play action. And incomplete on the deep ball. He was looking to go back to Cooks one more time, and that'll bring up second down.
It's second down and 10.
To throw again, Watson, and Stills over the middle.
Watson's pass.
They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
It's a gain of six. Makes it third and four.
From the gun on third, Watson. Strong coverage by Carolina. And on we go to fourth down.
Whether that's a little grabbing, a little hand fighting, by any means necessary on third down, he was able to get the job done in the secondary and swat that one away.
He had the distance, but it's no good. Line to the right. And this score will stay right where it is. Here again comes the captain of this offense, leading his crew back out there now. And he's been good. Two first half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence, does a great deal for your team, gives them a lead, and they feel really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
Second and three at the Texans' 47-yard line.
On second down, McCaffrey. And this has been a recurring theme tonight for sure. Nowhere to run. Back to the line of scrimmage, that's all. Call it no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a third and about three to go.
And four.
2 minutes on the clock in the second quarter of this Super Bowl. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Completes it to Samuel. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 13 yards, first down, Panthers.
That's a pretty good throw on the curl route there. Third down, and they pick up a first.
Defense should be aware for that, right?
They should be aware, but it was so hard sometimes.
Yeah, it's not easy.
Because when they sell that route really well, you think they're going upfield, then they curl back, show their numbers to the quarterback, and complete the play.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down. To the right side and complete to Thomas.
The pass.
And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
I don't care what sport you're playing.
And he'll take this in the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. From 19 yards away. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead. Point. is up to 8. That time a 6-play drive. And Carolina scores to cap it off.
Texans 13.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now on the return here, we've got an injured player down there. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
And he fends him off. But he can't get away forever, and down he goes. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. On third down, Penny. And he will be marked down short of the first as they get to him at the 29. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. On to punt now, Anger, as he boots this one away. There goes a 42, making a 43-yard punt. 6 on the return. Now out comes their leader and the captain of this offense back onto the field. And how about the start so far, Charles? 3 first-half touchdown passes.
And that's how you generate excitement on a team. Keep your offense moving at a really high level. And it's also how you establish leadership, by playing that well. 3 touchdown passes, that's the way to lead.
Now he's just open for number 4. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. That first down completion only netted him 3. 2nd and 7. Williams. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down. So we've come upon halftime in the big one, the Super Bowl. As we send you on out to our studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. What a season this has been. Hard to believe it ends tonight, as we'll get back to you guys for the second half of this Super Bowl in just a moment. It's been a tremendous season from beginning to end, and now we'll play one half of football to decide who raises the Lombardi Trophy. And for the call, let's get it right back to Brandon and Charles.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A 1-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in the Super Bowl. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
At their own 30-yard line.
Out comes the Houston offense as they get set to take over here. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works.
At the 34-yard line.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Back to throw, Watson. And a double cover.
coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 40, and they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. Tough one there. First drive of the third quarter, throw an interception, and now a chance that they could be an even a bigger hole if they can convert this into points.
Yeah, but how good do you feel if you're that defensive coordinator right now? Because you just know that the head coach looked at him and said, turn him loose, big man. And he'd be able to take a few extra chances playing with this type of a lead, and boy, it paid off.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. J.J. Watt able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening.
How about that, partner? His second sack of the game, and that puts him in some pretty good company. 17 guys have had two sacks in the previous 52 Super Bowls, but only three have had the record number of three sacks in this game.
And we've got the list here. If he gets another one and everyone behaves nicely, we might just list those out for him. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. And now a throw here secured by his running back out of the backfield. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and they'll be facing a third and 12. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He's going to drop this down to McCaffrey. And they'll get him down at the 34, and he's going to be short of the first by a few yards. A gain of 9, not enough, and it's fourth down. For the Panthers. He's going to need a little mustard on this one. It will be a 51-yard attempt. And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. Good. And the lead now 11, 24-13.
Texans 13.
So good kick there to polish off the drive with 3 points.
Yeah, coaches always talk about finishing a drive with a kick. Two of them give you points, either an extra point or, in this case, a field goal.
And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. And now out comes Houston. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
Now, that's a run that warms a play caller's heart, because you're actually set up to do whatever you want on offense. You come right back and run a sack.
Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. This would not be denied. That's a loss of 7.
Third and 10.
Following the sack, it's now third and long for Watson and the Texans. The gun, Watson. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. Give him 17 on the pickup there, and the Texans also get a new set of downs.
2-yard line.
First and 10, Watson. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. throwing again. Watson throwing the out route and complete. That's Fuller. Frustration penalty there because he's picked them apart.
They've tried their best to get to him and haven't done it successfully. A penalty as a result of that hit there.
And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Well, it's almost football 101 that you preach to your safeties. Don't let anyone get behind you. You're the last line of defense. But he didn't let the play come to him. He went to the play. How about that read and recognition and finishing off that one behind the line of scrimmage?
On second and 11 now, Watson. It's caught left side by Cooks. A gain of 13, it's a first down.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
On first down, Watson. Throw complete to Herndon. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
Second and six at the 20-yard line.
From the gun, here's Watson. He's got Herndon, his tight end. This will be a 5-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15.
That's a gain of five. Brings up third and one.
This will be play number eight here on the drive. It's third and a yard. Again, it's Watson. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete. Strong coverage by Carolina. And on we go to fourth down.
Fourth down.
Field goal unit and Joey Sly now.
A 32-yard attempt.
Kick is good. And that'll make this an 8-point game.
Makes the score Panthers 24, Texans 16.
He's got 9 points on field goals now. He's made three of them. That gets him a bit closer, but there's no question they need to start turning some of these threes into sixes.
And for him, it's not his concern, right? He just goes out there when they call on him and goes ahead and puts points up on the board. But the offense has got to get together and figure out what's stalling their drives so they have to keep calling on him.
Carolina getting set to take the field. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
And shutting him off now open field. He's at the 30. 10. And they're into the end zone, but it's not verified yet. Hold on, there is a flag down. So take away the long touchdown.
It's a cruel game sometimes, partner.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 14 yards, good for a Panther first down. But just a simple tap pass, but it pays off in a big way.
And sometimes the simple stuff causes the most problems for a defense because there's a